Hey everyone, welcome again to Fulltechstack. This is part 5 of important Angular questions and answers. As you know, we cover 5 questions per part, so I highly recommend you watch previous parts as well. Here are the next 5 questions that we are going to discuss in this part. What is Angular pipe? Pipes in Angular are simple functions that takes template expression as input, transforms it, and return the transformed output. To apply a pipe, we have to use the pipe operator within a template expression like this. And pipes are very useful because we declare a pipe only once and we can use it throughout our Angular application. That is, it helps in code reusability. You see, here we have a simple text hello along with Fulltechstack as an expression. Now, I want to transform Fulltechstack to all uppercase word, then we have a built-in pipe uppercase for transforming the text to all uppercase. Here, the text is now uppercased. Now, they might also ask you to name a few built-in pipes that you have used in your projects. So, I'm enlisting some commonly used built-in pipes in Angular for you. Date pipe, uppercase pipe, lowercase pipe, currency pipe, decimal pipe, percent pipe. You can also find the complete list by following this URL. It can also be found in the video description. Now, a sure shot question around pipes is how you can create a custom pipe. For creating a custom pipe, our primary step is to implement the pipe transform interface that resides in Angular core package, and then we can write our transformation code or logic inside the transform method. Let us create a quick example. In this example, we are going to accept a number as input and return the square of the input number. So, here we have created a class SquarePipe. Now, we have decorated SquarePipe class with this pipe decorator. And we have set the name of this pipe as SquarePipe. Remember guys, when we use a pipe, we call it via this name that we provide in the pipe decorator. We do not call it using the class name. So, don't get confused. Now, our class SquarePipe is implementing the pipe transform interface. And we have implemented transform method which will be holding our logic for the transformation. For this case, it is accepting a number and we are returning the square of the number. Now, how do we use this pipe? So, for that we can simply have an expression in our template file and we can make use of pipe operator and pipe name. Let us see the output. Since we provided 2, we got 4. Let us provide 5 and see. Here it is, now 25. And the best part is that we can now use it anywhere we want to calculate the square of a number. Hence, we are achieving code reusability. Now, if your discussion is going around pipes, then another question that they might put up is what are pure and impure pipes? But first guys, I want you to recall pure and impure changes in Angular. So, whenever we make a change in value of a primitive type like string, number, boolean, also, if the object reference of an array, object, or a function is changed, we refer these changes as pure changes. But if the element inside of an array or any other change within a composite object is changed, it is referred as an impure change. Understanding pure and impure pipe is now quite easier. We can simply say that Angular executes a pure pipe only when a pure change is detected. Also, note that by default, all pipes in Angular are pure. And impure pipe is executed when impure changes are detected. And to make a pipe of type impure, we can add pure property in pipe decorator as false. For a better understanding, let us visualize the pure and impure pipe. You see, here I have created a list of employees containing object with name and designation as property. And I have taken this sample data. Now, in our HTML, we are displaying a list of employees with designation as manager. And so as to filter this array, we have created a simple pipe that is taking the complete employee list as an input and returning us the filtered list of employee with manager designation. Now you see that I have added a button add manager that is pushing a sample employee with designation as manager. Now let us click on add manager button. Nothing happened. Let's click again. Do you think there is something wrong with our code? Nope. Nothing's wrong. In fact, this is our expected behavior. So, why didn't this button add a sample employee with type as manager or designation as manager? It is because it added the element inside the array, but since our list is being filtered with a pure pipe, it didn't get executed, as adding an element inside the array is an impure change, and pure pipe cannot detect impure changes. Now let's make our pipe as impure. Now you see that on click of this add manager button, our impure pipe is getting executed successfully, and it is filtering our employee list as expected. So a pure pipe is only called when Angular detects a change in value or a parameter passed to a pipe. And an impure pipe is called for every change detection cycle, no matter whether the value or parameter changes. Next, what are parameterized pipes? We know that we create pipes for transforming our template expressions. And in case we want to pass some additional information to the pipe we have created, we send them via parameters like this. We can pass multiple parameters using colon as separator. So we can say that for fine-tuning the output of a pipe, we can use parameterized pipes. We can even use multiple pipes on a single expression like this to fine-tune the output even more. This is also considered as chaining of pipe. By looking at this, we can also say that output of one pipe is becoming the input of the next. This was all for this part, guys. Do reach out to us via the comment section for any kind of feedback sharing. Also, thanks for watching.